Good morning. This is fine, no? Begin? Okay. So, good morning once again to all the remote center coordinators. Welcome to the Linux workshop. I hope all of you. Shall I do video sharing or screen sharing? Okay, so good morning once again. I hope all of you have registered on the spoken tutorial forum. If you have done spoken tutorial workshops earlier, definitely you have registered on the forums. But new participants, new coordinators can register on forums either through this register link, or if you were to go directly on forums, there is a register link there also. Okay, so when you do log in here, it will ask you to register. So please do that, then only you can post questions and answer questions. Okay, like Professor Kannan already mentioned, you can answer questions as well. We invite you to do so, but only one condition: please be polite and do not humiliate anybody for asking a question which may sound silly to you. Okay, because you are an expert. But they need answers. Okay, now how to use forums is you log in. Okay, so I'm going to log in here. Okay, and then you have the slider here. You can go through that slider, locate Linux or Bash or Linux for sysad, whichever series you have the question on. The other way is to locate the given FOSS in the column below. Okay, so now I have a Linux here. If I click on this, I can see all the questions that have been previously posted for the Linux series. Okay, so if I have a question which is exactly similar to what was asked before, I can view that question and I can read the answer as well. If I have a better answer, I can now post that answer as well. Okay, so this is what this is how you will access the questions and the answers from here. Now this is about basic commands. So now I go back to Linux by clicking on the Linux button there. So likewise, you can access all the questions. Okay, so you can arrange them in chronological, in sorting order. Okay, if I want to know by minute, if I want to know by question, alphabetically, which date or how many views. Okay, maximum views I can, minimum views. Okay, maximum answers, minimum answers, everything I can sort each of these columns as per my preference. Okay, now you want to ask a new question, this is a button here, green button on the top, ask a question. Since I have already pre-selected Linux as my series, it is in the drop down as a selected as my selection. But supposing I want to change it to Bash, which is the series that another of the series that we will be going through. So Bash, and then which tutorial. Okay, so select the tutorial on which you have the question, select the minute, the second, the range. Okay, and then post your, give us a suitable title to your question so that others can also relate to what you are asking. Okay, and the descriptive question over here, and submit your question. Now, like I said before, all coordinators are invited to answer the questions. If you know the answer, please go ahead. Otherwise, we have a team here. Our technical team is here today, and they will quickly answer your questions as you post them on the forums. Okay. Now, you have been given a set of tutorials which you downloaded from this link. We had sent this link earlier with the guidelines mail. The first link has the CD contents. Okay, you can watch it in the combination of language that you prefer. All right, there is also a pure English CD content here. Installation sheet you would have gone through to install. My technical team says that you 131 centers have already successfully installed Linux. So, you have gone through this sheet and you have used the OVA file to do so. Okay. Now, once you download the CD content in the language of your choice, you will get a zip file on your desktop. Okay. Now, what should I do here? Replace. Yes to all. Okay. So, what you need to do is extract this content on your machine. Okay. So, I have extracted and I get this folder spoken. Okay. When I open this folder, there will be four files and folders within this. Okay. There is a readme text. Obviously, we are expecting you to read this text. Okay. So, read it. It will tell you how to use the content which is extracted and on your machine. Okay. Always use the index.html file. Do not be tempted to open the videos folder, because when you open the index.html file, okay, I'm going to do it with Chrome. Please use Chrome or Firefox, that is recommended. Internet Explorer gives some display inconsistencies in some machines. Okay, so we recommend Chrome or Firefox as a web browser. So when you open index.html file, what you see prominently in the center of your screen is a side-by-side method to learn spoken tutorials. Now, if you have attended earlier sessions using spoken tutorials for either Scilab, Python, Moodle, Koha, eSIM, then you do not need to go through this video. But if you are a first-time coordinator, please watch this video at least up to 5 and a half minutes. It will explain exactly how to use the side-by-side method. Okay, so basically, what we expect is you open the video on one side of your screen, okay, you play it, you pause it, and then you open the console window. Okay, in this case, it will be the Linux terminal window that you will open, and you will do exactly what is shown in the video. Okay, now in this workshop, you should try not to experiment. Okay, stick to the content which is explained within the tutorial itself. First, gain expertise in that, and then you can experiment later. Okay, so you will watch the video, you will do exactly what the video says, you must get the identical results as shown in the video. Okay, so this is how you will do side by side practice. Right, now after you are done with side by side practice, you select click on the first drop down. Okay, this tells you which tutorials you are going to go through. So, in the sequence that we gave you, Linux is the first in the series. Okay. I had selected English and Hindi for my download, so I can choose the language of my choice. I am going to select English, okay, and then click on the submit button. So, now the index of topics that you need to cover in this workshop for the Linux series is displayed. Okay. So, when you click on any topic, I am going to click on the first one. So this is desktop. This is the second one. This is desktop customization. Okay. Now after I have clicked on the tutorial. Okay. Maybe I should just take the first one. Okay. Now immediately on the right of the player, you will see the questions which have already been previously posted. This is available in the offline content given to you. Okay. The live forums is going to be the live questions that you will ask today, which are not given in the offline version for today's workshop. For the main workshop, we will update the CD content. So, the questions that have been posted from today up till the date of the main workshop will be available for the main workshop offline content. Okay. So, you can read the question, you can read the answer over here, and here onwards, you need not go out of the screen. You can. The index is over here itself, right? Outline is given right below the player. Okay. Now, if I were to just come to basic commands, Okay. Now, when you come to the actual command line tutorials and all that, you will also see a link called assignment. Okay. These are assignments based on the content which is covered in the tutorial. So, we highly recommend that you do this. You do not have to submit it to anybody. This is for your self assessment. Okay. So, just practice them, go through the assignment and try to solve it. It will, give you additional confidence and additional learning, right. Now, once you are done with the Linux series, so this is the series, you go all the way up to basics of system administration. So, one coordinator had asked whether the Linux for SysAd series is not about networking, okay, it is not about networking. We are covering user and user group management in that series. So, when you come there, okay, so once you do Linux, you do bash, right. Again, once again you select the language, you will get the list of topics. These are the things to be covered, and then you come to Linux for sysads, right. Again, so like I said, this is about how to create a user account, how to assign groups to users, okay. So, like groups as in departments, computer science, civil engineering, mechanical, okay. How to manage the user password, how to manage groups of users, how to you can have clubs within your departments, or you can have clubs which are above the departments, right. All of this is covered in these tutorials, okay. So, you can go through them. Some of the tutorials will also have code files, okay. We have given some code files, like let me show you in which tutorial we have given a code file. So, in command line arguments and coding, we have given additionally code files. So, whatever we have used within this tutorial, the demonstration that we have shown, that code file is available in the code files link. Okay, so, you can download it, it will be a zip file, unzip it, use it. Okay, when you are practicing this tutorial. Now, for the main workshop, okay, instructions for you is given under each video player. You will see this link called as instruction sheet. Okay, ideally take a printout for each participant who is at your remote center, so that they can read the sheet before they begin the workshop. So, the sheet just tells you exactly what I have told you. Okay, now in the main workshop, you are going to be there conducting the workshop. So, this is the sheet that you can refer to, this is the sheet that you can give to your participants as well. Okay. So, the first section is about the content that is provided, the second section is about the practice method. Okay. Like mentioned earlier, you can either listen to the whole tutorial once and then come back and practice the second time, or if you prefer it, you can watch and hear and practice at the same time. So, we have given how you are going to practice. Okay. So, for each of the series, now this, because I have selected bash tutorial, this is a bash instruction sheet. When you are on the Linux tutorial, okay, let me do that also for you. When you are watching the Linux series, you will get the instruction sheet for Linux. Okay. So, here, right here it says Linux. So, for each series, when you are changing the series, remember to read the instruction sheet for that series. Okay. There are some crucial information given for each tutorial, or sometimes for some important tutorials, like now we have told you about the first, second and third, and then we have jumped to the 7th, 8th and the 9th and the 12th tutorial. So, there is something in this sheet which is not present in the video or is slightly different from what the video shows, which is why you need to read the sheet. Okay. So, you will not get stuck anywhere and you will have the necessary information to practice smoothly. Okay. So, please do make it a point to read the sheet today in the coordinator's workshop, and encourage your participants to read these sheets during the main workshop. Again, I am repeating, for each series that we are covering in this workshop, there is a separate instruction sheet. So, you can either take a printout for your participants, or remember to guide them just like I have guided you right now. Okay. So, this is how you will conduct the spoken tutorial workshop for the day. Like I said, we have a team here. Please feel free to post your questions. You will get quick answers today, and even till the time of the main workshop, if you have any more questions, if you would like to practice more tutorials, they are available on our website online. There is also a facility to download these tutorials from our website for offline usage. This is our website. You go to software training and create your own disk image, and here you can select the series. We have given you a selected list. You can go through all of the tutorials. Okay, there's an extended list on our website, so you can just go and download. Okay, create a zip file, and this place there will be a link which will be available for the next 24 hours. You can click on that link at your convenience when internet is good at your end, and you can download the content onto your website. You can also do a combination, like if you would like. So if I were to do a combination, is what we have given you today. Okay, so I'm going to do Linux all, and I'm going to do English and Gujarati, and I can do Bash, and again I can select languages that I prefer. I can go solely for English, or I can select any other language. Okay, when I do that, it will appear over here. So you can go through all the content that we have given in each of these series for further learning. Okay, for your own further learning, you can do that. But for this workshop, please stick to the content which we have given. Okay, so as mentioned, many more are available on our website. We have given you a select list for this workshop. The same select list will be used for the main workshop. And you can encourage your participants, like I am doing today, that there are many more in this series which you can watch at your own convenience for upgrading your own skills. Okay. So with this, I will end my session. Please begin the workshop now in the sequence that we have recommended. Yeah. And we will meet again with you at 12:30 for the question answer session, and at 5:30 once again for the larger question answer session. So goodbye and good luck.
So,